$7,000 for everything. That's including my plane tickets, my hotel, because I not only did I stay at a recovery place, but I also had another room at a hotel or whatever. So I had two places. I stayed with, what's his name, William Miranda. He's Cuban. Young boy. Young man, not young boy, young man. He was really nice. Like, you know, he waved on me hand and foot. Anything I needed, him and his mother, like, they were really good to me. So right now, I like to massage and rub, because like I say, it's still tender, but it's not tender to the point where I'm like in pain. Like, I'm still healing. I had about 6 sutures. My stitches finally came, they dissolvable sutures. They finally came out about, my last one came out about 2.5-3 weeks ago. So you can still see, let me show you. So you can still see the marks. You know, they're still healing. I got one right here, like right in the middle of my butt cheek. And then I got one in my tattoo. It turned into a little keloid. It's a little keloid. And then I have, let me see, one right there on my back. And then another one right there. I need to go back to using my Mederma because I stopped using it like 2 weeks ago. But I will go back and I will start, you know, using my Mederma. When I do my 3-month post-up video, I will have one closed. But I just wanted to show you guys, you know, how my results look. And I mean, I'm loving it. Like, I'm telling you, I love it. Look at that heart shape. It is nice. I mean, and it sits up. Like, it doesn't look fake. It looks natural. I have a little bit of dents, but hey, I mean, guys like dents. My husband like it, so hey, I'm not worried. I'm not trying to impress other men. Like, my husband love it. That's all that matters. I like it. You know, people that know me, you know, that have seen my results, they like it, you know. It took about a month. Because when I first got it done, like, it was literally on my back. And I don't know, you guys, please follow me on Real Self, because I have my before and after pics on Real Self. I do not post all of that information up on, like, regular social media, like, you know, Instagram, YouTube, Facebook. All of that information is on Real Self. Real Self is a private, personal, how can I say it, a surgery club for women and men who are trying to get surgery, trying to find doctors, getting price quotas. That's where all of my private pictures and personal, you know, where my boobs are hanging out, poop, you know, vagina everywhere. I don't want to put that stuff up on YouTube because that's not the place for it, in my opinion. I don't want to have my vagina all out on YouTube, okay? If you follow me on Real Self at Gorgeous, they all capital letters, GORGEOUS 330. You'll see me in some blue Walmart panties and a red corset. Red and black corset, and I have like a mohawk, a blonde mohawk or whatever. I change my look up a lot. I'm a hairstylist, so that's what I do. But look at the definition. Like, you can literally see my muscles, my tone. It looks like I go to the gym and work out. And I can't wait till the 3rd month come, because I will be able to go to the gym and start working out, you know, start toning up. And, you know, I mean, it just looks really nice. And, like, you can literally feel your muscles is firm, tight, you know. It's still healing. And even when you wear your faja boards, sometimes the faja boards will leave prints in the skin. That's how you know that you're not 100% healed yet, because you still have the imprints and stuff in your skin. But yes, I love my results. I love my new body. I would not have never changed anything that I've done. But I like my results. I love them. I wouldn't see, like I said, if I wanted to do another one, I have a little bit of fat. Like I say, in Miami, you know, they only can take out but so much fat. And that's why I chose to lose at least 15 pounds before, you know, I went ahead on and actually got the procedure, because I wanted to have the best. I didn't want to lose too much fat, but I wanted to at least have enough fat where you could see a change and a difference. And if you weigh like 185 pounds, your BM is like at a 30. But it's kind of good to lose at least 15 pounds, because after you had the surgery, you can easily gain that weight back. You know, I gained my weight back about a month ago. Because, you know, after you have your surgery, you're not going to really be able to eat all like that. You're not going to have much of an appetite. You're only going to have an appetite to need to eat what your body needs to eat for nutrition. You're not going to be eating all like that, you know, eating all crazy and stuff, because your body is not ready for all of that. But I tell you, give it about 2 months. Not 2 months, but like maybe a month and a half, honey, them eating habits gonna start creeping back on you. Like, honey, like, it ain't nothing. Like I said, I done gained my 15 pounds back, and it done came in my booty and in my boobs. But yes, I love my results. I wouldn't change nothing I did. Dr. Sergio did his thing, man. I mean, he did his thing. I love my new body. I cannot wait, like, to be able to be in a bikini, go on the beach. I haven't, like, been on any vacations yet. I haven't really done anything. So, I will be posting up a 3-month post-op video. And then after that, I think I'm going to wait a little longer to post up, you know, more videos. And then I'm done. I have to do a 1-year video, because they recommend that you do a 1-year video. And actually, the doctor, they give you a list telling you when it's time for you to do a video and take pictures. So that's the dialogue I'm following. I appreciate all of you guys who supported me, people that I don't know, but people who are interested in getting a BBL and wanting to go to Dr. Sergio. Because like I said, when I first was referred to Dr. Sergio, I didn't see nothing, like no pictures, no videos of nobody. Even though I knew that there was people that had the surgery done, but they wanted to keep it a secret. They didn't want to let people know that they was going to see him. So I'm taking this chance and just putting it out there, like, he is really a good doctor. I mean, Dr. Ortega is a good doctor too. I've seen some of his work. He does a good job. But Dr. Sergio, I can confirm, you know, that he is a really good BBL doctor. Like, he did his thing, and I don't have no regrets. I didn't have any complications. I still sit on my boppy pillow, because you have to sit on your boppy pillow. This is just one of my boppy pillows. I got two of them. I got the original boppy pillow, which costed me about, I think I paid anywhere from $60 to $80. I don't remember. But they came out with a new one. It's a leopard print one. But the boppy pillow that I got is like a black one. It has the actual thigh imprints in it, which just makes it so comfortable for you to sit in and your booty just hang over right at the bust cups. You ain't got to worry about, you know, sitting on your booty. Because, honey, I'm telling you, when you sit on your booty, it feels like you sitting on freaking sandbags. Like, that's how it felt for me when I sat on my booty. It felt like sandbags, honey. You can literally feel the fat. Like, but now that it's settling, my booty has dropped into more of the heart shape, you know, frame that I wanted or whatever. Because at first, like I said, it was literally, if you go on my Real Self page, you could see it. It was literally sitting up on my back. And I'm like, that look like a round. I ain't want no round booty. I mean, ain't nothing wrong with the round booty. But I'm saying, for me, I'm more of a natural girl, I like the heart shape because it's more feminine and more sexy, you know, to me, in my opinion. But hey, I've seen the girls with the round booty. That looks nice too. You got to go with what works for you. But for me, I chose the heart shape because that's what I like. And that's my natural body shape. If your natural body shape is round, then, you know, do your thing. Because that looks cute too, you know. But I needed some hips. I got my hips that I wanted. Honey, when I first got out the hospital, I'm talking about... When I first got out of the hospital, man, my booty was so perky and big. Like, people were staring at me at the airport. I was getting upset because I'm like, dang, why you gotta keep looking at me like that? I know my booty big, but I'm glad that it went down because it was too big from the swelling. Like, man. And you know what? You can also follow me on Snapchat, too, at Nicole Boyd, because I'm on Snapchat, too. I got a short haircut with, like, glasses on, and I'm doing the funny licking my tongue out or whatever. But follow me on Snapchat. I do post a lot of my pictures and stuff on Snapchat or whatnot. Be sure to follow me on Real Estate, Real Self, because that's where you really going to get the gossip and the info at my before and after pics. A lot of you have been asking me about my before and after pics. So you can go on my Real Self and check that out. I'm always posting up stuff on Real Self at least every month. I'm trying to take a lot of pictures. I'm really not the type of girl that really like to take a lot of pictures. But because I'm on this journey and I want to help other young ladies, you know, reach their goal and be happy and confident with yourself and with your body. That's why I'm doing these videos. And I appreciate all of the love and support that I've been getting from all of my followers on Instagram, on YouTube. I'm glad that I was able to help you guys out. And I hope that someday you will post pictures in your videos. And, you know, let me know. I will follow you back. I have no problem with answering questions of your concern. Or whatever. Another thing I've noticed, I am so glad this is just got on my mind. Now, after you have your BBL, you can't really make out for like 6 weeks. I'm telling you, your vagina is going to feel very different after you have this procedure done. I'm not going to say nothing more about it, but I'm just putting it out there. If you got a husband or a boyfriend that's packing... Be careful. I'm just telling you, be careful, because it feels like the doctor gave me a pussy rejuvenation. I am literally serious. Like, I'm telling you, man, that when those 6 weeks was up, I cheated a little bit. I actually did it 5 weeks. But that's a little bit of too much information. But I'm just being real with you girls. Like, I just want to put it out there. Your vagina is going to be very tight. And it's going to feel weird. But we are grown. I should be able to talk about this stuff. I hope I didn't offend anyone. If anything, that should have made you happy. Because, you know, men like, you know, wet, deep, gripping pussy. It is what it is. But... I'm just telling you, like, for real, after you done went 6 months without having anything, I advise you to make out the night before, because that's what I did. I knew that, you know, it was going to be a minute before I could be able to do anything. But now that I'm able to do, honey, I hope that man didn't give me no vagina rejuvenation. I know he didn't, but I'm just cracking jokes. I'm silly like that sometimes. But I'm telling you, your vagina even feels different. I mean, it's the same vagina, but it's kind of tight. Tight. I ain't gonna say kind of. I'm just over exaggerated, like really tight. So that's just a warning, just to let you know. I have not heard any other girls put that in their videos or talk about that, but I'm going there because that was the experience that I had when I started back, you know, making out with my husband or whatever. It was very tight. very tight. And I'm like, but I hope that helped you.